Hi, my name is Alana. I'm a second year student worker at the ASU Library. My major is Astrobiology and Biogeosciences with a focus on environmental conservation. Today I'm going to be taking you guys through one of my personal favorite hobbies, which is plarning. Plarning is the creation of yarn or yarn-like material with plastic bags. You take something like this, a standard grocery store bag, and you're gonna turn it into a sort of ball of yarn. To do this, you're going to need a couple of tools, but these should all be well within reach. You're gonna need a marker of some sort of scissors, a ruler or anything that'll mark measurements to about 3 inches, and of course, a lot of plastic bags. Plastic bag consumption is a huge problem. My hometown recycles plastic bags for us, but they go into the landfill. They don't get actually recycled. And so I came up with this in an effort to crochet homeless mats for the Cleveland area. And now I am expanding it to more practical uses on a college campus. Currently, I collect plastic bags from the community mostly. The library staff has helped me a lot in accumulating bags. Everybody has bags. And so no one really needs that many. I personally do not get grocery bags anymore, so I can only recycle what other people bring me. Everybody has them. They're very easy to come by. When you start, you're most likely gonna have a crumpled bag, which is not a problem, but flattening them out makes it a lot easier to work with in the future. So what you're gonna do to flatten it is you're gonna take the bag by both seams and you just pull it and it should fold. And then when you do that on both sides, you get sort of like what you grab from the grocery store before you put things in it. And you can just run your hand along it to flatten it out. And it'll end up like this. I'm gonna take you through cutting one. And once you are accustomed to doing that, you can layer them on top of each other and cut multiple at the same time. Your lines might not be as straight, but because this is a recycled material, it's not the biggest deal if everything isn't perfect. The purpose of this is not to have something beautiful, more to have something useful. Your current grocery store bags aren't pretty, so you might as well turn them into something that will suit you better. I orient my bag this way, sideways, so that I can cut off the handles first. The handles and the bottom of the bag are not going to be used for this project, but can be used for a lot of other projects. Especially if you do crochet, but even something as simple as having like a beanbag or anything that requires stuffing, these pieces are great to stuff and they don't make as much noise as you would think they make. If you're gonna throw it away, you might as well find somewhere to put it. You're gonna take your ruler and you're just gonna line it up with the bag. You don't wanna line it up quite on the top edge because this normally has the weakest plastic. And so it might rip if you use that by itself. We're gonna be making 2-inch strips for this, but you're more than welcome to make one, you're more than welcome to make three. It really depends on what you're making. The thicker your plarn is, the bigger and sturdier your project is gonna be. You're gonna need a larger crochet hook and you're gonna probably spend more time on it. The thinner your plarn is, the easier it's gonna be to work with, but it's also more likely to break. So that's just something to keep in mind when doing a project like this. So I'm marking it at every 2-inch interval. And then I left myself a little bit of extra room because I'm gonna cut this portion off as well. And so from here, I like to fold the bag so that I don't have to cut it as long. And then that way, I just have to cut a small strip and it'll cut the entire bag. So this piece I'm going to discard because it is not very strong and won't last me very long in the long term. And then this piece as well, because the seam here is not gonna make a loop, which makes it not usable for this project. And then you're just gonna cut your strips. They're gonna come off like this. They will be unfolded for the next portion, which is putting it all together. So once you have your pieces cut, you're gonna take them apart like this, and you're gonna have sort of loops. And these loops we are going to essentially tie together to create the big ball of twine. So you can take them all apart. It's super easy because it's folded. And just lay them out so that you can attach them to each other. My standard grocery bag is about 14 inches, and that gave me 7 loops and then a couple of scraps. And then for the formation of plarn, you're gonna take your first loop. This is gonna be the bottom. You can attach loops from both sides if you'd like. I personally like to make one long string, but if you wanna work from both ends, that's more than fine. So you're gonna take your first loop and you're gonna run your second loop through it. And that's gonna create a sort of T. And then from there, you pass one end through the other and you gently pull it. If you pull it too tight, it's gonna rip before it creates a knot. And then you could tie them together, but it's not gonna have the same thickness. And so once you have them knotted together, you have a sort of strand. And then you're gonna continue this process over and over again. Like I said, one bag is gonna give you about 7 loops. And to make any big project with 2-inch yarn is gonna be about 30, 40 bags. Once you fold them all, you can cut them all together at once and it'll make the project a lot faster. Once you have your desired length of yarn, you can go ahead and roll it into what this big ball looks like. You're gonna take the end of your plarn and just wrap it around your hand a couple times, the way you would wrap like a foam cord. And once you have a comfortable width, you're gonna take it off your hand and it's gonna kind of look like a loop. And you're just gonna wrap around that loop over and over again, and it'll keep going, and eventually as you turn it and keep wrapping, it'll turn into that ball there. And this is the ball of one entire bag. So for scale, this is probably about 40 bags, and this is one. And this is probably what you're gonna use for a project like a tote bag or a mat. If you're gonna make a water bottle holder or something like that, you're probably gonna only need about 20 bags, but that's also 20 bags that aren't going into the landfill. So anybody can make plarn. It's the can you figure out the logistics of crocheting? At the ASU Library, we believe in the importance of sustainability. If you're looking to expand your knowledge on the topic, we've got a great selection of books recommended by the experts at OpenStax. Feel free to take a look and see what interests you. Happy Earth Month.